Harmonics. What are they? What are the different types? How can I make them sound better? I will address all this and more in this short video. The first harmonic we learn divides the string in half, and it's an octave above the open string. Now, harmonics refer to the fact that all sounds have overtones, except for pure sine waves, but all sounds on a musical instrument have these overtones. So while we're playing an open string, and it's vibrating the length of the string, all these divisions of the string are simultaneously vibrating in their own wave patterns. And that is transmitted to the wood of the instrument that also vibrates in all these patterns, which gives the sound its beauty and richness. An exercise I like to give to beginners who are just starting to shift emphasizes the fact that when we shift, we want to use a very light touch. And when we play harmonics, we must use a light touch. And I'll show it to you quickly. So if someone's just starting to shift, they just find any harmonics as they go, right? So that's a very nice exercise to do. But now I'll do it slower so you can try to hear how the same harmonics down low get repeated up high, because those repetitions happen mathematically. And you will also hear that these notes are mostly in the G major arpeggio. You're going to hear some of those notes. You'll also hear a high A and some other overtones. So we have something called artificial harmonics as well. When we divide the string at the fourth, I can artificially shorten the string length by using my first finger. So that ends up being two octaves higher, right? Than the bottom note. So when you practice those, you want to make sure that you keep the first finger very steady down and that the fourth finger is very light, but the distance has to be exact or it doesn't sound nice. So you want to keep that frame and be conscious that as you go up the fingerboard, the frame gets smaller, similar to practicing octaves. But I find the mistake people most often make is there's just wiggling around, but you need to keep that. And we can also do it at the fifth. So if I play fifth up, it's going to be an octave higher than that. It's that E. So that's more of a reach for me with my small hand. So I make sure that my thumb is really under. My first finger is kind of a weird angle because I don't want to stress out this fourth finger. So we want to make sure when we play harmonics that we have a lot of bow speed. And the other interesting thing is, you also want to make sure your sounding point is close to the bridge. Normally, when we play with our sounding point close to the bridge, we can't move the bow quickly, or we get the ponticello effect, which is actually all these high overtones. I'll show you what I mean. So if I go normal, but if I play quick bow, sounds all weird, right? But if I'm playing harmonics, I actually want to do both. I'll show you, if I play it close to the fingerboard, it doesn't sound as good. It's kind of dull. So that's my advice for harmonics. I hope this was interesting. And let me know if you have any questions, if I didn't cover things you were curious about. And check out my violin practice tip playlist on this channel with so many different types of tips for technique and learning the violin for players of all levels.